Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and everyone I have missed, with a statement and with my heart, welcome to How to Be the Chosen Undead. thanks Mew for the raid, and everyone from Mew Stream. Welcome, I guess. Okay, so yeah, last time we stopped at Duke's Archive. We are really close to the end. We are just have to fight our way to the Crystal Cave, fight Cease, and then we can go back and fight the last boss. The last area is actually very, very short. If there's interest, we can also do some optional stuff. I can do the painted world, which I have skipped, or I can do the Darkroot Basin. No, Ash Lake. Sorry, I can do Ash Lake, or I can start the DLC. But I'm feeling like I have kinda done enough with this thing. I showed most of the game bosses, of the normal bosses, and showed how to get through the game. So I think I can get rid of the meme helmet, get back to my Wanderer's Hood. Yeah, I think I can kindle this bonfire, so I have a few more Estus flasks. And then we are gonna go through the Crystal Cave. The Crystal Cave has kind of a dumb gimmick. Or I can also pop a soul item to get get this level done. Yeah, that should be more than enough. And I think I need a few more endurance to finish our build. Okay, so off we go then. So how was everybody doing? Oh! I didn't expect that golem to be here. So that golem is part of the questline of Siegmire. And I think we can pull him alone. I'm just gonna do it. So we have done some of the NPC quest lines. But I specifically didn't. I didn't really focus on following them. So. I thought the strong attack would stagger those, but not the golden one, it seems. And the blue guy decided to take a very, very long route. Or is he just resetting? No, he tried to flank me. A very, very, very slow flank. And he even succeeded a bit. Okay, so I don't know if chat is working. Can somebody type something? I see I've few viewers, but it seems nobody in chat, and I have to. I have to get my bot. So, you might think this is Siegmeier, but if you look carefully, you can see this this girl, yeah, uses a bastard sword and not a zweihänder.
It was you who rescued me. Why, thank you. I am Sieglind of Katarina. I don't know how I ended up in that crystal. It wasn't terrible in there, but I could hardly move. I must think of some way to repay you.
And this is arguably the most badass character in maybe all of Dark Souls.
Oh, have you seen my father? You wouldn't miss him. A suit of armor just like mine. My goodness. I knew he
because?
Was somewhere. Well then, now I must find him. Thanks again, truly. Now if you'll just stay put and keep out of trouble. My goodness. Well then, now if you'll...
Because most, if not all other characters you meet are either demons or undead, so they kinda circumvent the whole fear of death thing, because undead just respawn at the last bonfire, but Sieglind is still human. So she's a human coming to this world full of undead just to take care or protect her undead father who keeps getting in trouble and yeah, she's just so badass. I think I can just run around these guys. That can happen. As with the last streams, I didn't do a practice run of this area before because I had I would have to catch up with my other save game. Yeah, you come at the right time. Just as I get smacked down a cliff. But good thing to know that the chat is working. I had worries there. Also, it is Splüsch. It's not Splüsch, it's not Splüsch, it's Splüsch. For anyone wondering, we argued about that in the last stream. There's a stream before this, not my last stream, but the stream we watched before this. No, not Splüsch, Splüsch! With an Ü. Okay, as you can see, this area is first relatively or really beautiful actually. It is inhabited by moonlight butterflies somehow. And the gimmick of this area is invisible pathways. The first one they make really obvious because this is a developer message. Normally, these messages are from other players, but this there are a few ones that are placed by developers, and this is one. And they also have this. It's not snow; it's something else. But they highlight the floor with this. A bit short. That was. I didn't take damage there because I used the invincibility frames of my roll. That's a very risky move. Because. Well, it's called invincibility frames, not invincibility seconds, so you only have a few seconds. And here I'm kinda relying on the fact that my strong attack does stagger that guy. This little edge is somehow my mortal enemy. Or maybe they changed the geometry in the remaster. Normally it's very hard to get up here, and I tend to slide down the side by accident. So yeah, the next bit of pass is here. So you can just drop down here and land on here and turn around, and here's the crystal is the cave of crystal lizards. If you need upgrade material, you can just stand here, quit out of the game and load back in, and you can fight the or kill the crystal lizards for loot. And that over there is some kind of slab, I think. Oh, I forgot. But there's not an invisible path that is straight, so you have to somehow navigate your way through. I think it's after the crossbow from the Duke's Archive, the next most annoying item to get, and I always skip it. So I don't remember what the item is. I would have to look it up. But from here you have to. I don't know how to make it easy, but maybe follow the this stalagmite, so like this and straight up. All the paths that are required are all straight paths, so just so you just to make this gimmick not horribly bad, all required paths are straight paths. It's just they knew their shortcomings. They made no required jumps to get through the game, and they made that part the required pass, straight pass. These enemies are annoying for two reasons. One, they are deceptively strong and quick. And two, they are for the next boss fight actually very dangerous. They can drop Twinkling Titanite, so this was before a certain patch the best way to get Twinkling Titanite, but they added Twinkling Titanite to the Giant Smith, so you can just buy it. But like I said, for the next boss fight you want to pull those three clams, pull them back, and then run in. I don't know if I did it right, because I certainly didn't do it right. Because the boss fog appears after this cutscene, so they can enter the boss area. Oh. While they are chasing you, for the first time only. After that, the boss fog is there, and so if I die, I don't have to deal with the danger of clamps. So if you hear a Dark Souls player say, "Oh, we've got clamps," that means they didn't either kill the clamps or... or manage to do the little clam dance right. So I'm gonna try to do the tail cut, because it's actually a good... It's actually a good strategy. Oh, we've got one clam. I think I may have to deal with the clam. Yeah, I did it. Okay, good. So this is Caesar Scalus. He is invincible until you destroy his destroy his crystal, the one I stood beside. The easiest way to kill him is to stand beside the crystal, wait for him to do his beam attack, so he destroys the crystal by himself, and then get behind him, because that way you get a few seconds of free attack while he's staggered by the breaking of the crystal. He has a few attacks. He has like beam attacks. He has this this crystal stuff on the ground that expands from him, and he can thrash with his tentacle things. I didn't dodge that right. So you have to be careful about that. Okay, I wasn't careful. Yeah, shit. Sorry. okay, now you get to know what curse looks like. It's been a while since I was cursed. So, if you're cursed, your HP is lowered permanently, like in the later games with the hollowing status, or in the earlier games with the phantom status. And like it says, we can get a healer or we can get a purging stone. I think I bought one at some time. Maybe I have it in my box. If I don't have a purging stone, it's no really big deal. Like you saw, I didn't take very much damage, so I'm just gonna And we already equipped the Ring of Favor and Protection. So I think all our equipments don't have curse resistance. So I guess we can use the Paladin armor to get more curse resistance, so that doesn't happen again. That would be a nice way to do it. No. So the Ring of Favor and Protection, we can't unequip it. without it breaking. So I guess it's a nice... we still look nice. Fashion Souls, hashtag Fashion Souls. And now we have more curse resist. Because we can get cursed again. Curse is also an insta-kill, and I think you don't even leave a bloodstain. So the few souls I had are gone, I think. I'm not sure. As I said, it's been a while since I was cursed last time. But also, luckily, I made a really silly build that just focuses on vitality and endurance. So I think that half bar I got there is what most people would have when they played Dark Souls normally. Oh yeah, also that golem here on this bridge that was really annoying to kill is a one-time spawn for some reason. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. This was what I was talking about. Somehow you are just slipping to the side. That killed me so many times unnecessarily. Okay, like I said, if you die once, you don't have to worry about clams. Because now there's the fog gate. Okay, try to. Also, my damage isn't as high as it could be, because Cease has exceptionally high defense for. Oh, I lied. The bloodstain was there. Exceptionally high defense for all elemental attacks, and I think magic. And of course, our weapon scales with humanity. I should take my time. Go back. Okay. Oh yeah, you have to destroy the crystal every time. So this one respawns also. And as you can see, if I destroy it, he staggers a bit. That's why I normally let him destroy it, because I'm near him, so I... Also, his belly is his weak point. So he takes a bit more damage on his belly. Yeah, maybe for the first time killing him, it's a good idea to equip a bit of curse resistance. So yeah, I guess no tail cut this time. Okay. So, using a equipping curse resistance makes the fight more manageable, because you completely eliminate one of the worst threats.
Okay.
I think if we will... I don't know exactly how much endurance I need for the... for my build. I think it was 54, so... Okay, we should get rid of this curse. So I'm just gonna run from... Undead Parish. To Oswald. Because Oswald sells purging stones, if I remember correctly. You can also run all the way down to New Londo, to the sealer, and get it removed from him. But that run is more dangerous and more annoying and longer and... Yeah. Purging stone is definitely more expensive. I think 5,000 for one. But at this point of the game, it's whatever. Yeah. I nearly forgot about this one. These are 7 humanities and a pendant. Okay, this is a bit hard to remember whose corpse this was. I want to say Rhea, but that doesn't really make any sense. Oh, the pendant isn't even a key item. Of course it isn't. pendant. A simple pendant with no effect. Even so, pleasant memories are crucial to survival of arduous journeys. This is the same pendant you can use as a... or you can choose as a starting gift. And as it says, no effect. It doesn't have any effect. In the early days of Dark Souls, there was this great gold rush treasure hunt to find out what the pendant does. But nope. It does nothing. Like it says. It isn't lying to you. So it's just Miyazaki being a troll.
Greetings, and welcome back. I am pleased to see the preserving and humanity.
Did we sin? Oh, we did sin. What? What sin did we do? Oh, it's 3,000, not 5,000.
Not welcome, and it is only human.
Oh, we killed, No, wait, we didn't. I honestly don't know what sin we did. Oh, sorry, the purging stone has a very, very interesting description. Ash-colored stone encasing a skull. Secret treasure of Arstor, the Earl of Kareem. Reduces curse build-up and breaks curse. Humans are helpless against curses and can only redirect their influence. The purging stone does not dispel curses, but receives them as a surrogate. The stone itself was once a person or some other being.
No one welcomes any, it is only human.
So... Yeah, it's... They use a human to... No, it's... If you've seen... if you've seen Made in Abyss, that's what it reminds me of. But I guess nobody has seen Made in Abyss. Oh Gott, what have I done? I'm way stronger now, so you can't even do anything to me. Yeah, remember when I died here? To exactly the same situation? Yeah, that's mostly my armor and my huge health bar. Yeah, in Made in Abyss, there is also a thing called Curse that triggers when they ascend from the Abyss. So you can descend down, no problem, but if you try to ascend, you get a curse. And they... I guess this is half a spoiler, but further down, there are these guys who can move freely up, can ascend freely up, because they have the suit which has a surrogate in the backpack. So they are just using other humans as a surrogate to receive the full front of the curse, and it doesn't affect them. It's that's a kind of anime. I think as we are approaching the end, I'm gonna unveil the full build I planned for this. I guess if you know anything about Dark Souls memes, you can already guess what I wanted to make. Where is it? I'm sure I've bought one. Didn't I? Oh, maybe I didn't even buy it yet. Okay, so it seems I didn't want to unveil the build too early. So I'm buying my armor set now. I have to wear the armor set for the boss. At least for the last boss. I thought maybe I could get it earlier, so I would have a longer time with it. But as it turns out, that's a lot of endurance you need for that build. Yeah, maybe as I'm slowly approaching the end, I can say my impressions about how the remaster was handled. And I think it's just the same game. How many souls have I? Okay. It's just the same game, but on the Switch. It's just a portable version of Dark Souls. Oh, he wants the crystal amber, of course. I has shiny. He's a good boy. Yeah. This is my armor set. I'm pretty sure if I unequip the gloves.
Yeah.
I'm one endurance away from making this build. So this is the infamous meme build, the giant dad. I'm gonna do the emote so you can clip it. Where is it? Yeah. This is the build from the video where the Get Good meme and the What Are You Kazool meme and the base cannon and whoops. So the Chaos Zweihänder has a nickname Base Cannon because of that video. And in the early days of Dark Souls without any patches, this was a very viable build. Because it has high defense, it has fast rolling. It has a huge amount of HP and stamina, so you can roll quite a few times to annoy your enemy. And I guess I can pop a few souls to make the build complete. I think it was 54. 54 endurance. 12 dexterity, starting strength of the bandit, and the rest in HP, and I think 2 points in attunement. Oh, 10 dexterity only. So if we use a few of our souls, it's already 30,000. Maybe this is already enough. Yeah, it is. So now we can equip our gloves and still fast. No! What did I do wrong? God damn it. It's 50 of 177. No, it's 28. Huh. Maybe they changed it. Maybe you can't make this build with just 54 endurance. But we can just wear the Elite Knight gloves. Okay. As you can see, Sieglind.
Oh, hello again. We're both managing quite well, aren't we? But I haven't found my father yet. Have you seen him?
We did see him last in Anor Londo.
Really? Then I must be off. I'm sorry he's caused you trouble. He has a knack for that. If he just stay put.
I don't know how to trigger the good end or the bad end. So I'm gonna keep it at that. I'm not gonna finish this questline. As there's no activity in chat. If there were any activity in chat, I would now ask if I should do some optional stuff to fill the stream more. But as there is nobody, I'm just gonna finish the game. So I'm gonna go to the last area. So, after beating the four lords and gathering the four lord souls, you can put them in the lord vessel. So many lords. Putting a soul in the Lord Vessel also counts as kindling the Lord Vessel, or the bonfire that is the Lord Vessel. So putting four in there now kindled it, so we can we get 20 essence flasks. This area, this little stairway was always so cool, because these my screen hung up. I think the game froze. Okay. Interesting. I'm quickly gonna restart the game. Maybe it helps. So okay, that rarely happens on PC, I think. Either the game completely crashes, or I don't know if it really froze like that on me one. No, thank you. Okay. Yeah, sorry about that, I couldn't really, it was out of my control. Okay, let's hope we start somewhere where we left off. And hope we can actually finish the game. I hope it isn't reproducible on that staircase. So I'm gonna try to run now. And it seems fine now. Okay. I don't know what that was. Okay, so this last area. First of all, it looks very interesting. So you come here and think, what happened here? There's ash on the floor, everything is burnt and molten. And it seems like there was like a fire whirl around the center structure. So all these things have like a rightward swirl to them. By this time, you should be able to handle these black knights by either fighting the silver knights, which have similar movesets. Of course, the black knights all have different weapons. If you really want some black knight weapon, you can farm it here. So this is the last area of the game where you'll be able to where it gives you the opportunity to farm it. Oh, that was too early. I think I'm just gonna use my strong attack. Because, like with most enemies, the strong attack of the Zweihänder easily staggers them. Oh yeah, like I said, you can get their weapons here. Also interesting, these drop all the different chunks. The sword one drops the Titanite chunk, this one dropped the red chunk, and the other ones drop the other chunks. The blue one and the holy one, the white one. And yeah, I think that's about it. Oh. As soon as I committed to that attack, I thought, nope, that was the wrong attack here. Okay. So yeah, the drop rate is actually relatively high, so if you really like the Dark Knight armor, this is where you get it. It looks very similar to the Silver Knight armor, but it doesn't have the faults on the sides, if I remember correctly. It's similar, but still different. Black Knight armor. Oh, no, it doesn't have the cape. That's it. It looks a bit sleeker and it doesn't have the... it doesn't have the cape. It does make your head look really tiny. Somehow. But yeah, back to our meme build. Or our meme armor. That guy always has to start with this super sick jump move. Oh, normally he does it. Maybe not, today is not his day. Ah, now he did it. I slashed him out of it. So yeah, that's the white Titaner chunk. And that's the Halbert guy. Okay, that was very dangerous. And that was also very dangerous. And the attack was also very dumb. Stairs are very buggy. They totally mess with the hitbox, as you can see. So if you do PvP, don't fight on stairs. It's really not fair. Okay, so this is a fog gate for the last boss. Are we ready for this? Yeah, I guess so. So I'm gonna... Yeah, I'm gonna tell you first talk a bit about the boss. The boss is a human-sized character with a big sword. He's very agile and he is very hard if you don't try to parry him. So he's one of the few bosses in Dark Souls 1 you can parry and riposte, which makes him super easy. But you can also fight him without parrying, which makes him a lot harder. I think I will do the one without parrying first. Maybe I get it. And if it doesn't work, I try with parrying. But I'm really rusty with my parry timing. So I think maybe I can do it without parrying. Okay, so it is... I think I already said it at one time. It is... Gwyn is the last boss. And he's gone hollow. So he just attacks everyone who comes here. Even though they are literally trying to do the same thing he did. So I'm just trying to help him. I'm just trying to take him out, basically, to give him an opportunity to don't be linked to the fire anymore. But hollows don't really sink, they just attack. I can trade hits with you. My armor is really good and I have lots of HP. He has a grab move attack. So even if you are... If you try to block everything, he has a Z grab attack. Which does a lot of damage like every grab attack. But our Zweihänder can't stagger him with a strong attack. Nope. Okay, he gave us time to heal there. Okay, I'm trying to do the parry for the finish. Nice. Okay, now that Gwyn is dead, you realize how much he radiated, how much fire he actually radiated, and the fire here is out. This is the point where you can decide if you are gonna do the bad ending or the good ending. Nothing you did before matters. If you go right back out of this area, of this boss arena, you get the bad ending. If you link the flame, touch this bonfire, you get the good ending. If you want to call it that. You get one ending and you get the other. As I've called this series How to Link the Fire, How to Be the Chosen Undead, so you want to link the fire. Of course, I am gonna link the fire. And both endings have different credit songs. So if you like one credit song more than the other, choose that ending. So that was Dark Souls Remastered. like I said, it's just Dark Souls. It's just the same Dark Souls I know and love. But portable for the Switch. The lack of 60 FPS didn't really bother me much. Even though I played with DSFix, I mostly played with 30 FPS because my PC is a bit weak. So it was really, really similar. I liked the added bonfire at Vamos. It made the catacombs a bit less scary, because you can actually do the catacombs early and get up to Vamos, get the bonfire, and then teleport out. I think that still works in Dark Souls 1. Or try to get back up. And I managed to get back up in the catacomb stream. So that's a viable strategy now. Before, you would go down and fight Pinwheel, and then get the bonfire in the Tomb of the Giants, or just warp out and drop down the next time again. I guess with the catacombs shortcut, it doesn't really matter that much, but I don't think the catacombs shortcut was ever intended by the developers. I would certainly recommend this game for players new to the series who just want to experience Dark Souls for the first time. If there's anyone who still can do that, it's certainly a good version of the game. Still, I think the PC version may be the better version because of the capability of mods, so you can get higher resolution graphics. There is a slight performance issue in Blighttown, which is fixed with the remastered version. I don't know about the modding capabilities of the remastered version on the PC. And also there's that you can't really get the old version on the PC anymore. That's scrubbed from Steam. What can I say? Yeah, I really liked doing one full long series on my channel, because I normally did just short games. And the longest was Unravel, which was, I think, 3 or 4 streams. So that was the thing. I know of myself now that I can commit to a game to stream every week for so long and manage to get a full playthrough out of it. Yeah, if you finish the game once, you are just gonna be put back in the cell, so this part of the intro sequence.
Yes, indeed.
Replays.
The dark sign brands the undead. And in this land,
I can talk over it. We already have seen this. This is literally the exact same intro sequence, with the only exception
where they are locked away
that our character wears the stuff we had on when defeating the boss. So there we have our giant dead.
This is your fate.
Yeah, the rest is the same. I'm gonna put the meme, the giant dead meme video in chat, so it's in the VOD. If you want to see how this character became a meme. There, we have all of our stuff, except for the key items. Also the bottomless box, we still have that. Yeah, the rest is all the same. Yeah, and we could go and replay the game now with a slightly inflated numbers. This. Now I can focus on this guy more. I think I ran past the first time and didn't want to pay too much attention to it because I didn't want to highlight that there's a semi-secret boss. But yeah, it was nice to once again play through Dark Souls, visit Lordran, and I don't know what I can do now. I don't have anything prepared. I guess switching games. I could switch games, but. It's still just 1 hour, and I don't know what you guys want to see. Yeah, it's a bit sad, it's a bit too short, but I guess I had a very busy day, so I guess I'm gonna end it now with a short stream, with a short 1 hour stream. I guess I can switch to the to this scene again. So yeah, thank you guys, thank everyone for watching, thanks for following me through this journey, and I hope you have a wonderful weekend. I hope you have a very pleasant evening, which is now elongated by 1 hour. And I hope I see you on Sunday for Pokémon Let's Go, or next week for something different, which I haven't decided yet. Yeah, thanks everybody for watching, and I haven't decided on a cheesy ending thing to say, so I'm gonna say, may your heart be your guiding key.